absolute risk is essentially the actual probability of an outcome happening within a tested environment. So obviously there's a lot that goes into that. It's not 100%, but it's supposed to give you some idea of what the risk is. And relative risk is looking at the absolute risk and then finding the relationship of risk increase or decrease within two subgroups of that experimental group. So let's try to make this really simple. Let's say that we have two groups that we each have 1,000 people that we're gonna study. One group exercises a lot, one group doesn't exercise at all. We wanna know if the likelihood that you get hit by lightning is greater, increased or decreased based on how often you exercise. Now, obviously these numbers that I'm giving you are completely fabricated. They're made up, they're simple, they're for the sake of this exercise exclusively. So please don't attack me for the numbers. So let's just say we have a group of 1,000 people who work out regularly. And out of that group, 5 of them get struck by lightning in the course of our experiment. In our other cohort or group, we have 4 people who are hit by lightning who never work out. So we can compare these two groups and we can say, what is the absolute difference between these two groups? Well, it's 1, right? 5 minus 4 is 1. So that's our absolute difference. And if we're looking at that statistically, it's simply 0.1%. That's the difference. That's a teeny tiny difference. No one would really ever think there was anything to report on that because obviously your rate of exposure to lightning is probably not at all impacted by working out or not working out. So that would be the end of it. If we were really interested in outcomes, we would be looking at that absolute risk. What happens all the time, in fact, I would say more often than not, relative risk is what is reported, both by scientists and by journalists. And I think I honestly don't know that that many journalists really get this, but I also think scientists are incentivized to come up with impactful results, significant results. And then they're also incentivized to get more headlines for those results because the more their papers are cited and the more they're recognized, the more likely they are to get more funding and all that other stuff that we talk a lot about at the Broken Science Initiative. Okay, so what would our relative risk be? And this is really a relative risk increase. So we're looking at the difference between these two numbers, right? So now we're going to look at 5 and we're going to take away the 4, right? But instead of leaving it there, we're looking at the relationship between them. So we want to know what is the rate of increase. And so what is rate of increase? Well, we're just going to take, you know, the percentage of 1 in 4, which we all know is 25%. So we would say the difference between these two cohorts is 25%. There's a 25% relative risk that increases if you work out. And so you could theoretically, and someone might run a headline that says, working out increases your risk of getting hit by lightning by 25%, study finds. Now, would that be fair or accurate or giving you information that's going to help you in your life? Probably not, because the absolute risk was totally missing. Now, we saw this during COVID. This graphic will show you of how the relative risk was widely reported and really didn't tell you much without the absolute risk also being a part of the story. Absent from including absolute risk, I generally think throw the story out because they're not really giving you a basis for how likely this is to happen to you or to somebody. So when you see things like study found a rate increase of blah, blah, or your risk of doing X, you know, increases this outcome or anything like that, you want to dive into the article or the medical journal study and you want to see what was the absolute risk. Absolute risk is essential to understanding outcome. And again, relative risk is sort of like the sexy way of spicing up your results, but not necessarily informative at all. Certainly, it's not useful without absolute risk also being included.